Okay friends, here are some topics we discuss now. The Indian Railway Training Institute Manufacturing Unit is the most important for the upcoming examination like NTPC, okay, RRB JEE and other exams. It's the very important part. The first is the National Academy of the Indian Railway. It's called a Railway Staff College. It's called Railway Staff College. Sometimes asked in the exams. Now, where is it located? It's located in Vadodara. Okay. The next question, the Indian Institute of the Civil Engineering. Like those who cleared the ES examination was conducted by UPSC. After that, is completing joining, this goes to a training. This institute located in Pune is called the Indian Railway Institute of Civil Engineering. Similarly, the Indian Railway Institute of Signal Engineering and Telecommunication, those which cleared ES as respective subject, the Electric Engineer and Communication, is goes to training in Secunderabad. And similar, and the Indian Railway Institute of Mechanical and Electrical Engineer is located at Jamalpur. Okay. The next one is the both electric and mechanical engineer. And the next one is the Indian Railway Institute of Electrical is also located at Nasik. But major thing is only the electrical engineer is and going training in Indian Institute of Electrical Engineering College. But the combined mechanical and electrical engineer and the ES officer, you can say, and AN and some others who's posted in railway department is going to training at mechanical and electrical, both is combined at the Jamalpur. The next one is the Indian Institute of the Transportation Management is going training into Lucknow. Okay. The another one is the Indian Railway Institute of the Financial Management is located at Secunderabad. Those who cleared economics service examination was going to training in Secunderabad. But only those who student is going in this colleges and institute who's cleared UPSC exams, you can say UPSC Indian Economic Survey, Indian Economic Service, Indian Engineering Service, and some other structures is, and sometimes the RRB Railway Recruitment Board also is going to conduct exam is called a Section Engineer and Telecom Engineer. Signal engineer is those who clear these exams. Again, he goes to this institute for the training. So this is the most important parts of this Indian Railway Training Institute of Manufacturing Units, and this is the Railway Training Institute. Next one is the Manufacturing Unit. The next one is Manufacturing Unit. How can we find the how many manufacturing unit is related to railways? The first one is the Chittaranjan Locomotive Work, where is manufactured the engines, is located at Chittaranjan, West Bengal. And the second one is the Central Organization of Railway Electrification, is located at Allahabad. And you know the electrification is going on to 2030, our target to achieve all lines is on electric. Okay, and then is third one is the diesel locomotive work, where the diesel's engine carry out to maintenance and the new is located at Banaras, Uttar Pradesh. And the diesel loco Modernization Work is located at Patiala, Punjab. And fifth one is the integral coach factory is Chennai. Integral coach factory Chennai, and rail coach factory Kapurthala is the very important, and the rail wheel factory is Bangalore. Rail wheel and axle factory called and sub plant is located at Bangalore, Karnataka, and modern coach factory is Raebareli. is the Raebareli. Raebareli modern coach factory is the one of the most highly equipment and robotics machine available in the modern coach. So it's called a modern coach factory. Raebareli is the second one. Is the rail wheel plant is located at Chhapra, Bihar. It's now in operation, and diesel component factory in Dhankuni, West Bengal. The first slide you can see is the Indian Railway Training Institute, and next here is the railway manufacturing units, and next here the some important facts from railway. Okay friends, this is the most important because it's the several time in asking examination directly. Okay, like NTPC, RRB, JEE, and some other exams related to where is the questions asked from railway. Okay, so please see the first train from Bombay. Okay, where to where you can see here. Sometimes ask the whose train is where to release and where is termination station and what is date to start it. Okay, the first train of the India is started from Bombay to Thane is 16 April 1853. Okay, I think it's the first marks of your question, first marks of your examination. Second one is the first passenger train started from Howrah to Hooghly in 15 August 1854. Okay, first passenger train, if they ask question, the first passenger train it is started from, and the fill in the blanks, and then to fill in the blanks and what it did, you can easily tackle this question. And third one, the first electric train is our 1925, and third of the Feb is started from Bombay Victoria Terminus to Kurla. Okay, to Kurla. Okay, and the first Rajdhani Express, the first Rajdhani Express also from Howrah to New Delhi is the 1969, 1st of the March 1969. Okay, here is those whose train as presented is the rapidly asking several examination. Okay, so next one is the first Shatabdi Express is started from New Delhi to Jhansi in 1988. Okay, first Garib Rath Express, Saharsa to Amritsar, 4th October 2006, and now in operation. The first Duranto train, Duranto Express, is Sialdah to New Delhi, September 2009. Okay, the first Rajya Rani Express is the highly affordable, and for price is more for the normal fare, but you can going to this train, you can feel you come in a palace. You can come in a palace. The first state Rajya Rani train in operations in Mysore to Bangalore in 1st July 2011, and the first Humsafar Express is Gorakhpur to Anand Vihar 16 December 2016 is almost where is the 1500. Okay, it's third AC only, is contacting third AC and several times on this. The first Antodaya Express Ernakulam to Howrah is the 27th February 2017. Okay, first Tejas Express is Mumbai to Goa. Okay, Mumbai to Goa 22 May 2017. Okay, 2017. The now is the some remarks here. You can see some remarks here. The first underground railway in India started in Kolkata in 1984. Okay, in yes 1984. Now the first train also come from Bombay in 1953. 1853, and the first underground railway in India started in Kolkata in 1984. Okay, and now next is the computerized passenger reservation system was introduced in Indian Railway in 1986. You can say the IRCTC. The IRCTC is the website, is the official website of the Indian Railway, where you can take ticket. If we can say, you can take a reservation for any trains. But the first questions in our mind, where is it started? What are the time to start this function? The computerized passenger train reservation system was introduced in India and the Indian Railway in 1986. My friend, here is the first marks I already told. But here is the last one, is the your second marks. Okay, here is the your second marks is the most probable to the ask in your questions, and the third marks is the remarks also. Okay, the 1984. So friends, the first you can see Indian Institute of Railway, then Union Indian Manufacturing Plants, and now here the first Indian Railway and important facts. And I'm going to move to the towards. And the here are some major parts of this railway is, okay, of this railway. So look it, the longest in Indian Railway. Here is the topic, is the longest in Indian Railway. And what the longest in Indian Railway? Now is the longest platform in the world. Now is in Gorakhpur, is the 448.2 feet, okay, overtaking the Kharagpur 2733 feet. Okay, the here is the you can firstly ask the question, the longest platform in the India and the world. Me as also take a answer as the Kharagpur, but now remember, now at a time the Gorakhpur is the longest platform in the world. Okay, is the overtaking the Kharagpur 2733. You can change in also in the meter. You can change it in also in meter. So you can find, just 1 second, I'm going to change it. Okay. You can find the Gorakhpur platform, its length is 1366.33 meter. Okay, and the Kharagpur platform length in meter 1072.3 meter. Okay, so this is the longest platform from now in the Gorakhpur and he's overtaking the Kharagpur. And the next one is the first marks you can complete it here. So I'm going to you the second marks. The longest rail journey between Dibrugarh to Kanyakumari. So what are the distance? The distance is 4 to 86 kilometer. The perform by Vivek Express. What the name? Vivek Express. And now going to say something about Vivek Express. The Vivek Express is started from Dibrugarh. Is going to Kanyakumari. Okay. His introduced in 2011. The prior of this, Himsagar Express covered the longest distance from Jammu Tawi to Kanyakumari. His distance is 3751 kilometer. So friend, the remarks in your mind, ki past you can cover this Himsagar Express to the cover the longest distance from Jammu Tawi to Kanyakumari is the 3751 kilometer, but now at a day time 2019 the Vivek Express is the longest distance covered by this train is the 4 to 86 kilometer, the longest rail journey by Rajdhani Express between Hazrat Nizamuddin to Tiruvanthapuram covering 3149 kilometer. If question asks the longest journey by Rajdhani Express and where to where and what the distance covered by it, okay, so you can say the 3149 kilometer. Remember, is the three marks you can get. One in the first one is the first mark, second in the second marks, and third one the third marks, and then the Bembanath railway bridge connecting the Ippadili to Balapardam with a length 4.62 kilometer is the longest railway bridge in India. And here friend remarks the Bogibil, you can say Bogibil is the longest railway path also, but he is only asking to you is the railway bridge, not to railway and road bridge. So friends, do not marks to Bogibil bridge is the longest in railway and road bridge. Okay, the Bembanath is railway bridge connecting to Idapalli to Belarpadam. Okay, length is 4.62 kilometers. Okay, 4.62 kilometer. Okay, and I can say something about it. The Bogibil bridge length is the Bogibil jo Bogibil rail road bridge is Bogibil rail road bridge. Okay, its length is 4.94 kilometer. Okay, 4.94 kilometer. Okay, and this bridge is Bembanath railway bridge located at Kerala. Okay, located at Kerala. Total length is 4.62 kilometer. Okay, there is a fourth marks to be completed. Okay, here 4 marks completed. And move it next. The longest railway tunnel, Pir Panjar railway tunnel between Kujigan to Banihal, is the length of 10.96 and almost 11th kilometer. And the work on work the tunnel completed in October 2011. The prior this the longest tunnel was the Karbur tunnel of length is 6.5 kilometer Maharashtra. A part of this Konkan railway. But now at that time, the Banihal and the Kuji, in between the Banihal and Kujigan, is the Pir Panjal, okay, railway tunnel is the longest railway tunnel in Indian Railway. Now at that time, okay. movement next factor come from railway. The miscellaneous information, the why it needs for us, the Konkan railway pass through Sayagiri mountain in the Western Ghat, it in connect Mumbai to Mangalore. If ask you the where the Konkan railway passed and what the mountain and where is located, so you can simply give the answer is the Sahyadri mountains in between in the Western Ghat, it connect the Mumbai and to Mangalore. And the next one, the India with rail network of 66,687 kilometer as record on 31 March 2016, the rank the fourth in the world after US, Russia, then China. You can see the first in US, second one is Russia, and third one is the China, and the fourth one is India. Okay, the total electrified route of Indian Railway is 21,614 kilometer. Is the data is collected by 31 March 2014. Okay, move it next then. So what state with the longest railroad network in Uttar Pradesh? Okay, the state with the longest railroad network in Uttar Pradesh with 9,077.45 kilometer is a data on 31 March 2016. And now I already told the state with no railroad network in Sikkim, and then nowadays you cannot find in railway in Sikkim. Okay, but the Ministry of Railway is also going to tackle this, but I don't know what the time taken by ministry. And the next one is the more computerized passenger reservation system, PRS, passenger reservation system of Indian Railway is the largest passenger reservation network in the world. Remember this point, the PRS, yani passenger reservation system of Indian Railway, is the largest passenger reservation network in the world. It's available at 2,222 location with more than 8,074 terminals. Okay, so this is the miscellaneous information about railway. And going to next, the previous slides you can find the, this is the most important points is taken taken from me, because the is the every time you can get the marks 3 to 4 only these slides, only these slides. Okay, the previous three slides 5 to 6 marks is related to railway. Okay, railway exam. And move it next slide. Here is the Darjeeling Himalayan Railway, the Nilgiri Mountain Railway, the Darjeeling Himalayan Railway, the Nilgiri Himalayan Railway, and the Kalka Simla Railway is the collectively known as Mountain Railway of India, classified at the World Heritage Site by UNESCO. The first things you can consider, if the question asks the how many railways is taken by UNESCO in the World Heritage Site, you can simply answer this like the first one, Darjeeling Railway. Okay, first one is the Darjeeling. Second one is Darjeeling Himalayan, and third second one is the Nilgiri Himalayan Mountain Railway, and third one the Kalka Simla Railway. Okay, the all are the mountain railway. Okay, so UNESCO is put it in the World Heritage Site. Okay, next Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminal. Okay, is known as Victoria Terminus Station in Mumbai, is also a heritage site, also a UNESCO World Heritage Site. And after that, in this completion of this lecture, you can also provide you the how many World Heritage Site in India. Okay, Bolu, you can say Bolu, already know Bolu is the elephant, is the mascot of the Indian Railway. The Fairy Queen is the world oldest working steam locomotive, the plying from New Delhi to Alwar. The you can say the Fairy Queen is the oldest working steam locomotive and now is working in and also going to Delhi to Alwar, Rajasthan. Is Alwar located at Rajasthan? Okay. The world first railway timetable were designed by George Bradshaw. Okay, his name is George Bradshaw. So, the most important first marks you can get here is the final. And Nilgiri Mountain Railway has the track has rack section of line from Kallar to Kunnur. Elevation is 1,712 meter. You can see almost the length is 1.7 kilometer, almost 1.5 more kilometers. This is the only place where the rack system is used in Indian Railway. Okay, rack system using Indian Railway. And move it next. The station which has all the three gauge narrow meter broad in Siliguri station, because Siliguri deals with the Darjeeling Himalayan Railway also. Okay, and some others is localized train is run on meter gauge, and the mountain Himalayan Railway is run on narrow gauge, but our main railway is run on broad gauge. So next one is the northernmost and easternmost, southernmost and the westernmost railway stations are, the northernmost is Baramula, okay, Baramula, Jammu Kashmir, okay, eastern Lado, and southernmost Kanyakumari, and westernmost Nalia. So you can remember this and you can also get one marks of this. So this is the miscellaneous information about, and after that railway you can move at road after that next lecture. I hope you can enjoy it and remember to get almost 10 marks of your examination.